Good morning, everybody. As promised, we're gonna do the catfish skin and gar skin sheaths. Hang on. I'm gonna show you this one I did yesterday. This is the blue catfish skin. The one that JNL Zero caught and sent me. It came out very, very nice. Real happy with it. The only exception is this dries, it gets almost transparent. And it's starting to lose the color. See, there you can see my finger through it. And what I had to do is put it over some leather. This leather right here. Because the skin by itself is not thick enough to support the knife. Anyway, that's that one. Now this one I'm going to try. Instead of leaving the leather natural, I've got some dark color on the leather. And all that is paint, spray paint. And I think when I lay it down on there, we'll be able to see more of the color that's in the skin. Actually, this is the piece here. So all I did, I laid my piece down on there and traced it. See it, now I'm gonna cut it. Now, cutting it bigger than what it needs to be. Because from here, it's gonna go out in the sink into some water, because what I want to do is rehydrate this partially. I don't want to rehydrate it all the way, just a little bit. And this will be the outside here. As you can see, that's the side where the meat was. And it'll have, that was right down the back, the darkest color on there. So let me put this in there and get it. It'll take a few minutes to hydrate it back. And then I'll show you how I'm going to glue it to this leather. And when I get to the gar skin, I'm going to include that in this video also. It's going to be basically the same thing, but I'll have to work with a couple different tools. I have a brand new pair of high dollar EMS scissors that I actually cut a penny in half with that should cut that gar skin just fine. Master Sergeant brought me those. He found them somewhere on sale and got a couple pair. And the biggest thing about those is right now is finding where I put them. They're right here somewhere. And after these get started gluing up, this table has got to be cleaned off. I'm working in chaos here. But all right, get this and I'll show you how to glue it on there in just a minute. All right, got my skin soaked. Now it's not slimy. Good and dry. All I want is, I want it to be damp. I don't want it to be wet. So I'll take this leather, dampen it with just a little bit of water. Not much, just a little bit. And that's going to activate this glue, which is good old Gorilla Glue, waterproof glue. And I like this for this kind of stuff because it sets up fairly quickly. It's waterproof. And once it's glued, it's glued. It's not coming apart. Get this down here where you can see it. I'm just going to squirt some around like this. See that? There, that better? Take a piece of cardboard. spread it out real good. It's also good not to put too much of this on there because this is expanding. It'll foam out and expand. And it's best to use rubber gloves. But you see mine? Because if it gets on you, you can get it off with alcohol, rubbing alcohol, or denatured alcohol, or something like that. Or in my case, most of the time, it just has to wear off. All right, now we're going to take the good side up. Lay it on there like that. So it's real flat. Push the air bubbles out, most of it we can. Put a piece on top of it, put something heavy on it. Like the little anvil here. And let it dry. And like I said, this it sets up fairly quickly, probably 30 minutes or so, 45 minutes. It'll be dry enough to fold. I don't want it completely dry when I make the fold because the skin's going to give a little bit. This one did. It didn't give much, but it gave a little bit. Now that leather being that dark color, should be able to see the dark color. This is actually blue, but in the... it's so transparent that it turned brown color. Still very nice. I like it. All right, we'll come back to this here in a little bit. And did I say I found my scissors? Yeah, I found my scissors. I put them in the drawer instead of hanging them where they're supposed to go. All right, I'm gonna get the gar skin out now and get started on one of those while this is drying. All right, to the gar skin. Okay, I've got it sort of flattened out here. I've got my sheath pattern. I'm gonna make two of these. So I have a pair of Wallace ones, the big bushcrafter over there, ready to be handled and finished. Mostly done. And those both will be available for sale as soon as I get done with all this. And I'll show them again. And they will be... I haven't figured out a price yet, but I'll figure that in and we'll see. Now let's see if these EMS scissors are going to cut this. Cut it a little big. Well, they cut. This one still smells a little fishy. But it won't by the time I get it glued up and get the urethane on it. It won't smell like that anymore. Ow! That will cut you. Can y'all see what I'm doing? I'm not paying attention to the camera, am I? And that's going to be just big enough for one more. All right, let's get this out of the way. That's what that size is going to look like. Clean this off just a little bit. Okay, now I'm gonna do the same thing with this one as I did with the catfish skin. I'm gonna put it in the water, hydrate it just a little bit, because when I started to fold it a little bit, these scales are starting to move. So if they're wet, I don't think they will. And I'll rehydrate it and I'll cut a piece of leather just like I did for that one. Now this is thick enough and heavy enough like it is, but it's pretty rough. It'll scratch the knife up real bad. So we'll line it with that thin leather. All right, we got our gar skin down on the leather. Isn't that pretty? We're just going to put this down on it. Make some little homemade hold downs. There we go, and that'll hold it flat until it dries. That may take a little longer for that one to dry. Now let's take a look at the catfish skin. Okay, see where it's starting to expand. Oh yeah, I think we'll keep more color in that one. That's the ticket. Okay, now I'm going to cut a welt, piece of leather to go in here. Glue it down. Fold it. And let it sit and dry. Then I'll trim everything and we'll work on the stitching. Alright, our glue is almost dry on the gar skin. Yeah, ain't that pretty? Now as I fold it, a couple of these scales are going to break up, but I'll sand those off before we put the final stain on it, and I think they'll be fine. Now I trimmed it here just a little bit so I can line it up better. Turn that radio down. Now I'm going to glue in this welt here. Dampen it just a little bit. Activate that glue. Now this is turning into being a little bit longer project than I thought it was. But and I have a few orders that I've got started. I'm waiting on confirmation from another one. Got plenty to do. Mailed out one this morning, Mr. Bruce. Yours is on the way. I can't turn out as many knives quickly like I used to, but it's all good. Everything's coming along. It's almost to the point in the shop here to where I'm going to have to crank that AC. It's not going to be much longer. Got a little cool down coming this weekend. 50s and 70s. Cool for us compared to what we've had lately. Now just gonna clamp that down for a few minutes. Now, when that dries, I'll just fold it and glue that side. Now, well, I got to sew the belt loop on first, and we'll look at that here in a minute. Now, let's take a look at the catfish one. That's what I want right there. That pretty blue color, bluish black color. Let that dry a few more minutes and then I'll just take and trim off the excess, put it over on the grinder, smooth it, then I'll drill the holes and stitch it, and other than drying and the finished coat of polyurethane, that'll be done. What's that the old southern boys say? That's pretty right there. Very satisfied with that. Alright, you got to go find me some water and a sandwich of some kind, and I'll be back in a little while. I got some help in the shop now. What you doing?
I'm making a special house.
A special house?
Yeah. With lots of cool stuff.
With lots of cool stuff?
Yeah. This is how it looks. It's taller than it used to be. And what does you have?
Well, that's an antler tip.
Antler tip? Well, I'm going to make it as part of my house.
You are?
Yep. Because look, oopsie, I dropped it.
Okay, we'll get it in a minute.
Okay.
Okay, well, I got to cut some wood. You keep on building on your house, okay?
Okay, I need some more of this wood to make it. So can you give me a few more wood and then I'll be done?
Okay, you need some more blocks?
Yeah.
Okay.
I need one to put right here.
Oh, okay.
To make a big... Because right there is where it finally touches.
Oh, okay. Tell everybody bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, let's see what we got done today. Now, I didn't video all of the gar skin sheath. I left out the stitching and all that because it took me 3 tries to get it glued up and worked. That is very hard material to work with. And forgive me, but I said a few words that are not family friendly. But that was a tough job. But let's take a look at what we've done. There is the blue cap sheath. Came out very nice. I know the camera don't do it justice. And you've already seen the knife. There's the knife there. That is for Chris, who is the 2016 catfish champion. Alright, that one's done. And y'all remember this little skinner here, a little fillet knife, which was named by my buddy Tim as the regular dude fillet knife. Now this one belongs to J-Nail Zero. Whoops. If I don't throw it down. And I modified the catfish skin sheath on this one. And this catfish skin, it don't have the, you can't see the blue color in it, but that's what it is. It's a blue cat. And that is for John, because he caught the fish, so he gets the scabbard. Now this one. Now I'm proud of everything that comes out of my shop. If I'm not proud of it, I don't send it out. But I think this come out real nice. Now there's only two of these. This is the gar skin. Alright, this is a Wallace one. Y'all seen plenty of those. Let's see, let me make sure you can see it real good. Said the camera don't do it justice. It's got three coats of water-based polyurethane on it. Now the trouble I have with this, I kept sewing it up with the sinew, which I like artificial sinew to sew with. But I sewed it up once with it, and the scales on here are so sharp, even after I drill the holes and try to clean them out, that they kept boogering up the thread. So I switched to a micro cord, which is micro paracord. Very, very tough stuff. And it's got a double stitch on that. And that seemed to work pretty good. So there it is. There is the gar skin sheath. Well, that thing is pretty. Now there's only two of these. There's going to be two of them. Because the other knife is already made. And there's enough skin for one more. So if you want to get in early, these are going to be $150 a piece. Alright, there'll be two of them. If you want both of them, I'll pay the shipping. If not, we're going to have to add $10 for shipping. And well, that's about all on those. Alright, look at it one more time. Look at it that way. I know it's not for everybody, but I started at about 7:30 this morning, and it is 5:45 now. So I worked on this thing all day long. J-Nell spent a day catching the thing. They spent a bunch of hours getting it skinned, cleaned, tanned, all that stuff. So there you go. $150 I think is a very fair price. And there's two. Until J-Nell catches me another gar, or if I catch another gar, because we have the same kind of gar here, but I just don't have time to go to the river and get one. Excuse me. Not saying I will get one if I go, but I mean, they're there. I have caught them before, but I might have to go target those one day. And because they're good eating, plus the skin, and you can't beat that. Pardon me. Now the pollen level here is at an all-time high. Back to the garden. I told y'all every year it rains and rains and rains and it'll quit. And it has quit. Anyway, like I was saying, pardon me for that. Had to get some water. It's very, very dry. The pollen is real high. And if you have allergies and breathing problems like I do, it's just brutal right now. They're calling for a little bit of rain, maybe on Sunday, like a 30% chance of maybe an afternoon thundershower, but who knows? Can't put no stock in that. Well, all right, somebody's calling me, so hang on, let me see who that is. All right, before we're interrupted again, so let's take one more look. There's the gar skin. There is the catfish skin. Like I said, the camera don't do this justice. This is really, really pretty stuff. And there's that catfish skin. Jay, no, catch me another catfish and another gar. Let's wear out of stuff. Let's see, what else was I going to say? I've got quite a few cards in for the giveaway. Thank you all for those. But it's not many. It's just a little stack about like this. So y'all please get your cards in. Friday's the deadline to send them. But you can actually send after Friday, because not this Friday, but next Friday will be the drawing day. And I'll wait till at the post office, they post all the mail in the P.O. box by 10 o'clock in the morning. So I'll go about 11:30, 12 o'clock that morning. I've got a doctor's appointment that day also. So I'll go to the doctor and I'll come back by that afternoon and I'll check the mail on Friday, and whatever cards are in there, everything get put in the bin. So y'all get your cards in. The P.O. box is down at the bottom. I thank everybody that sent cards in. If you send a great big card like this, Reuben, I'll take a 3x5 card, write your name on there, and put it in there. We don't know unfair advantages. Staff Sergeant, you know who you are. But y'all please get your cards in. And about midweek next week, I'll have the prize knives and the shovel and all that stuff ready to show you of what we're going to give away. So all that said, I'm just about wore out for one day, so I'm going to go inside and get something to eat, get a shower, which everybody should be thankful for that, and I'll see y'all in a couple days. Thanks for watching.